existence is futile.
Boldly going where no show has gone before. This is the Week in Geek with David D. Squared, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. Broadcasting from the Gregory Ricks and Associates Wealth Management Studios, here's D. Squared.
Greetings, people of Earth! This is the Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. I'm your host, D. Squared. Holy crap, I'm tired. And to help me be tired is my boy Scungy. Scungy, I smell bacon. Is that a sign of a stroke? I'm not sure.
Maybe it is. I don't know. I'm tired too, bro.
I wanna thank all the fine people at MechaCon. MechaCon Omega has happened. We survived it, and we're here to talk about it. And I just want to thank all the staff and all the people that made MechaCon what it was, the years of success that they had. It was a great final send-off to MechaCon Omega, and thanks for everything they did for us and for the city, really, you know?
This is going to be a huge void that's going to be left from this show. I mean, this is the biggest convention. I mean, you could say Wizard World is big, and it is, but that's more like a trade show. This is your old-fashioned hotel convention. This is the biggest one in the state.
Yeah, I mean, just the sheer amount of, I don't want anybody to take this the wrong way, but kids, and it's the younger kids that we were when we were tearing up the city, and now they've got a new generation of nerds that are terrorizing and tearing up the city, and it does my old heart well to see that, and I'm wondering what's gonna pop up in July or August next summer when we don't have a MechaCon. I mean, I'm curious as to who steps up, who tries to take over the crown, or if something else, you know, kind of fills in that void. You know, who knows? Maybe they'll have a music venue or something. I don't know. Who knows, man?
I've heard some rumors, some rumblings, and, you know, who knows? Who knows? But, I mean, it would be crazy not to even consider doing something like that because, I mean, you look at it this way. People are prepared at the end of July to come to New Orleans for a big event.
Yeah.
A geek event. So, you know, it's already on their calendar. So all you have to do is just open up the doors.
If you build it, they will come. All right. Let me lay out the show for you real quick because we have a lot of great guests tonight. And I want to thank all the people that we got to meet. We were shaking babies and kissing hands. Strike that. Reverse it. We talked a lot about all the guests that we've had in the past. So one of the things we told everybody about was Jamie Lee Curtis and how she gave us a For the Horde. And so obviously we are going to have to do that. And I just had For the Horde. Wait, here it is. Hold up. Wait for it.
For the Horde.
There she is.
For the Horde.
Jamie Lee Curtis. So we'll replay that. But we have three brand new interviews tonight. It'll kick all off with Jeff Bergman, who is the new voice of Bugs Bunny in the new Space Jam, A New Legacy movie that's out now on HBO Max and in theaters. And he's also the voice of Yogi Bear now in a new HBO Max series called Jellystone. So we'll talk about that. And I play a quick game with him, Scungy. I play the Hanna Barbera challenge, but I play the Jeff Bergman version because he also does the voice of Fred Flintstone, George Jetson, Yogi Bear, and Bugs Bunny. And so I basically ask him, yeah, I know, dude does a lot of voices, and you'll want to stick around for this interview because he switches from voice to voice when I ask him, okay, Captain Caveman versus Fred Flintstone in a death match, go, who wins? And he just starts talking like Fred Flintstone. It is just sheer radio magic. That's Jeff Bergman. Then we have Sarah Wayne Callies. You remember her as Lori Grimes from The Walking Dead. Now she exactly. I crap you not, Scungy. I told her during the interview that I despised her. I told her that. I don't know what's wrong with me. But I told her that I despised her, and she goes, thank you. She's very magnanimous, but it's because she's an amazing actress. And she goes, and this, I'll tease the interview. She goes, look, it's not my job for you to like me. It's my job for you to believe my character. And I'm like, well, you sold it hard, lady. You sold it hard. I hated you. And then, and then, Scungy, we're going to wrap it all up with none other than Robert Hayes Stryker from Airplane. And you know I'm a giant man.
Surely you can't be serious.
Surely I am, and don't call me Shirley. I am a giant man child, and let's just say there's a lot of farts going on in this interview, because Leslie Nielsen used to torment him with a fart machine. And I'll just leave it at that. People are going to want to stick around and hear that interview with Robert Hayes. So all that's coming up tonight. Jeff Bergman, Robert Hayes, Sarah Wayne Callies, and we will replay Jamie Lee Curtis. But first, let's do this. And now, your top nerd news stories from around the world, brought to you by the Viridian Tea Company. Find them on Etsy. And now, your top nerd news stories. We only got one story, Scudgy. One story, and it is going to be the Loki finale. The Loki finale. It's been over a week now, so if you haven't seen the Loki finale, A, what the hell is wrong with you? B, what the hell is wrong with you? The Loki finale. Let me just say this. I was completely underwhelmed and just kind of got bored halfway through the episode and was like, please get to the point. And they kind of sort of got to the point, but there was so much exposition, and all of it was kind of, I felt like I stayed in the theater with a bladder that was filled to bursting, and I'm just like, please end it so I can go pee. And that's what it was. It was just like a giant teaser at the end of the movie that you've watched an entire movie, and then it's just like, oh, by the way, here's the multiverse. Ta-da! Fade to black. I felt let down. I didn't feel like Game of Thrones hot garbage let down, but I did not feel like I got any closure on anything to do with Loki. I didn't feel like I had any closure on any of the storylines. What's going on, with Sylvie? You know, is old man Loki maybe still alive? I don't. There's so many questions, and they didn't answer any of them except that it's Kang the Conqueror at the end, and he's the big bad. And I don't know, man. I was underwhelmed and unimpressed by the ending of Loki season one, man.
I don't know if I necessarily agree with you. I get where you're coming from. I 100% get where you're coming from, because compared to the last three episodes, especially the one where we had all the multiple Lokis, that was just bang, 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 and then everything slowed down to a crawl, and most of the episode was a conversation.
Yeah, and it
Which,
kept
there's
going on.
There's nothing wrong with that.
No,
there's nothing wrong with that, but
okay, finish.
You know what? It is kind of like the writing was on the wall. It was foreshadowed a lot throughout the entire episode that she's going to sit there and she's going to end it. And you're going to open up the multiverse. So kind of like 20 minutes into the episode, I'm like, I know what's going to happen.
Well, here's the other thing, though. And I felt like they did a disservice to Kang the Conqueror, because even though he seemed to be Mr. Omnipotent and all-powerful at, the he who survives, whatever the hell they call them, he who remains, I felt that they didn't do him justice as a villain, because now I'm not excited about Quantumania and seeing Kang the Conqueror, because I was not... there was nothing about that Kang, He Who Remains, where I was like, oh my God, I need more of this villain in my life. I was just like, okay, he's there. He gave us a whole bunch of exposition, and oh, my other guys are really bad. You should watch out for my other variants. They're really bad. Don't kill me because they're really bad. And then they kill him. And so, okay, these other guys are really bad. I told you they're really bad. I do not consider Kang like a villain now, and I'm not afraid of him moving into the next phase four of Marvel. I think that's all of that, and you jumble that into a freaking blender, and that's my weird-ass feelings about the greatest series I've seen up to date, and then they crap the bed at the end. Not as bad as Game of Thrones, but I just felt I felt cheated and robbed almost. That's
I don't know. I mean, I think it's more of a setup. They're trying to set it up where it's like, you know what, this guy is not, and it's gonna be. I think Kang's gonna be completely different than the character than we saw. He Who Remains. I think it's just gonna be completely.
I would hope so because he was pretty friggin' boring.
But you are. There's one thing that you're like missing on the whole. This whole thing is what that episode has done for the potentially next 10 years of the MCU.
Yeah.
Everything is free game again.
I know, but see, that's not the point of the television shows, though, man. I mean, it's like,
they gave me
a 6-hour commercial trailer for, hey, now you really got to go watch the movies, Phase 4, in theaters near you, unless COVID comes back, then it's back to Disney Plus. I don't know, man. I feel like Marvel sort of cheated us on using this as the platform for the movies. And I mean, I understand that's what they're supposed to do, but I just felt completely robbed. And I don't know. I felt cheated because the Loki story, the Sylvie storylines were all friggin' phenomenal. And then it's just there. I don't know. I mean, look, if they bring back, I mean, they're already going to do Loki season 2. I've left the series left me with more questions than answers, and they should have at least tied up some of the other stuff. Not like, stay tuned, get to the theaters, Phase 4 is a coming. Hold the Wells Fargo.
Wait a minute.
Coming down the street.
Who are you?
I'm an angry man. That's what I am. I'm an angry
man.
No,
I'm saying that's how they ended it. They ended it with him going like, okay, calm down. Who are you?
Oh, you mean what's Loki? Oh, I thought you were asking me who I'm just an angry person.
No, I know who you are. No, but I mean, that it does kind of a let down with that. You're like, but...
I know him.
You're right. There are way too many questions.
He and Lightning McQueen were supposed to ride off on a jet ski in the sunset eating, alligator bites, something. I don't know. I don't know. I just felt cheated on that. All right, Scungy, let's get out of here because we have Jeff Bergman coming up next right here on The Week Geek. No, as always, though, we want to strongly urge you to check out the Facebook page, facebook.com/ The Week in Geek. Check out our website or not, twigradio.com, or follow us on Twitter at Twig Radio and the Instagrams, The Week in Geek. Hey, Scungy, how can people listen to this show?
Well, if you missed any part of tonight's show, or if you want to hear your favorite part again, you can always find us on Spreaker.com or download Spreaker for your smartphone or tablet. We're also on iTunes, YouTube, Google Play, Stitcher, Spotify, and that iHeart Radio app. But hey, really quick, I would like to just thank, once again, our hardworking show staff.
Oh, my God.
Jared, Cynthia.
And Michelle.
And Michelle.
Oh, my God. Thank you, Scungy. I'm an awful person. Yes. Oh, my God. We could not have done it without Jared, Cynthia, or Michelle. They saved our asses on more ways than we can possibly count. Thank you to those guys. Sinful Cosplay. Go check her out. And Jared, I don't know. I know he takes pictures for a living, so hire him. Give him money. We like him. Keep him around. All right. This is The Weekend Geek on News Talk 99.5 WRNO. Box tea again? Why don't you try the tea blends from the Viridian Tea Company? They sell blends that are guaranteed to make you think outside the box. With blends like Quantum Mechanics, Caligula's Herbal Nerve Tonic, and Manta Ray Dreaming, your tea experience will be out of this world. Look for the blends at Tubby and Coos Mid-City Bookshop at 432 North Anthony Street or online at Etsy at the Viridian Tea Company. So put down the box and order some tea from the Viridian Tea Company today. Sincerely, your taste buds.
Everyone listen! No one quits! This is Casper Van Dien, Johnny Rico from Starship Troopers, and you're listening to the Week in Geek Radio Show! Come on, you apes! You want to live forever? Kill them all! You know what to do! Service guarantees citizenship!
Welcome back into The Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. I'm your host, D Squared. Let's go to the guest line. voice actor extraordinaire. His new show on HBO Max comes out July 29th, Jellystone, the voice of Yogi Bear and Bugs Bunny in Space Jam, A New Legacy. Jeff Bergman joins us. Jeff, how are you today, sir?
Well, I'm fine, Doc, and it's true. I'm the voice of the rabbit.
And Yogi Bear.
It tickles me so much. I don't know why. That is awesome. Jeff, how did you get into this? I know a little bit about that you jumped in as George Jetson and Mr. Spacely. Did you ever get a chance to meet Mel Blanc, or was it because he passed? Now, this is kind of a depressing, crappy way to open up an interview. Sorry, man.
No. It's actually a really cool story. I met Mel 40 years ago on the campus of University of Pittsburgh while he was giving a performance lecture, and I just happened to find out where he was staying, and I got to talk to him for about 45 minutes. So that was a moment, like a watershed moment for me. Changed everything about my whole life.
That is amazing, dude. And so then you kind of sort of jumped in there, and you've been doing this ever since. I mean, we literally don't have time to name all the voices. But let's talk real quick about your new show, Jellystone, coming out on HBO Max as your Yogi Bear. But it's like all in this town of Hanna-Barbera characters that we probably haven't seen in, what, close to 20, 30-some-odd years, huh?
Yeah, it's pretty amazing. I mean, I grew up with the Hanna-Barbera characters,
yep,
Huckleberry Hound, Yogi Bear, in the late 60s, early 70s. So to have this show, Jellystone, it's a universe in the town of Jellystone where all of these Hanna-Barbera characters live, Jabberjaw and Captain Caveman and Augie Doggy and Wally Gator. Wally Gator was one of my favorites as a kid. Wally Gator, everybody's favorite swinging alligator.
Like, I was like Snagglepuss. Exit stage left even. I cannot do voices though, but...
And Snagglepuss is in it, and then of course you know, I also do Mr. Jinxie. You know, I hate those Mises the pieces. You know, so he's in there too. See,
so now the world is sort of based in the city of Jellystone, but everybody's kind of like got like day jobs. I was wondering. I know like Magilla Gorilla sells, you know, like bow ties and stuff. Is there some poor schmuck in Jellystone who sells pants and is always doing a going out of business sale since nobody in Jellystone wears pants?
Hey, that's a good idea. I hope the writers are listening, because I don't know if that's the case. But I do know that Yogi is a surgeon. He's a doctor in this. So if you can imagine that.
No.
Because he's a surgeon. And Cindy and Boo Boo, they all work in the hospital at Jellystone. So and perform ridiculous, medical operations.
That is awesome. We're visiting with Jeff Bergman, voice of Yogi Bear, in the new show Jellystone on HBO Max, July 29th. Space Jam, A New Legacy is out now. You play old Bugs Bunny opposite LeBron James. What was it about this movie that attracted you to it? Because, I mean, it's like it's got the whole cast of characters in there too, man.
Well, you know, having the first film, you know, really, that was something that we all, you know, we're mindful of. And in the new film, A Legacy, we pay homage to the first film. And so it was an honor to be a part of this because LeBron James is such, not only, you know, one of the great athletes of all time, but just a great guy and the way he lives his life. So to be a part of this, it's a dream as Bugs Bunny.
And it's true, Doc. Space Jam is the number one movie. So that's all, folks.
I don't know why. I'm so tickled by this. I love that Jeff Bergman is our guest. Look, I got a chance to watch it with my 8-year-old. And it's funny, too, because he was so entranced during, like, the game sequences where you've got the entire Warner Brother cast out there in the stadium, in the stands, watching the game. And it was so funny because he just sat there, like, playing the Easter egg game, like, ooh, there's so-and-so, there's so-and-so. I thought that was a really great little thing to have in the movie, man.
I'm so glad you bring that out, because really it's a big party where everybody sort of, you know, shows up and you recognize somebody. It doesn't matter what generation you're from. I mean, there's a moment in there where it's the Wizard of Oz, and then there's, you know, the Mystery Machine,
yeah,
and you know, you see the Jetsons, and you know, it's just there's a lot going on there. I mean, I've seen it twice. I have to see it a third time again just to catch everything.
That is awesome. All right, Jeff, we only got about 2 minutes left, so I want to play a quick game with you. This is the Hanna-Barbera Warner Brothers Bracket Challenge, Jeff Bergman edition. It's basically a death match against a bunch of your characters that you've played and Hanna-Barbera characters. Fred Flintstone versus Captain Caveman. Who wins in a death match?
Oh, I definitely would think Fred Flintstone, with his wits and his clever way of thinking. Plus, he's also got his pal, Barney Rubble. That's right, Fred and I would win for sure.
George Jetson versus Snagglepuss, even.
Well, I would have to say that, I don't know. I guess Jane is not too good with that, so I'd obviously have to depend on my boy, Elroy.
Jetson, get back to work. Otherwise, you're fired.
Yogi Bear versus Bugs Bunny. This is a tough one, man.
A bear is pretty strong, you know, and I got my claws, and I like to eat everything. So I don't think Bugs Bunny would stand a chance.
Oh, carrots are divine. I would just sing him to death. And he would never survive. La da 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 dee.
Fred Flintstone versus Yogi Bear.
Oh, just hold it just a second here. Yabba dabba doo takedown.
Yes, there we go. That is our Hanna-Barbera Warner Brothers Jeff Bergman Bracket Challenge. Jeff, thank you so much. Congratulations on all your work. Jellystone out July 29th on HBO Max. Jeff, thank you so much, man. I really do appreciate it, bud.
Thank you. Smarter than the average bird.
All right, coming up next, we have Sarah Wayne Callies, Lori Grimes from The Walking Dead. But she's got a new podcast out now with David Harbour, with Jeffrey Dean Morgan. It's called Aftershock on the iHeart Radio app. So stick around for that. That is coming up next right here on The Week in Geek on News Talk 99.5 WRNU.
His boy Elroy.
What do you get the nerd who has everything? A gift card from D4 Tabletop Gaming Cafe, and let them figure it out. D4 Tabletop Gaming Cafe at 8228 Oak Street is open for the holidays. So head over and check out their expanded inventory of miniatures and miniature paints, board games, RPGs, TCGs. Or you can reserve a table for your next game night. Find them on Facebook at D4 Tabletop Gaming Cafe or go to their location at 8228 Oak Street, just two blocks off of Carrollton. Or go to their website at d4cafe.biz.
Now back to The Week in Geek with D Squared. Tell your friends, tell your enemies. Yeah, definitely tell your enemies.
Welcome back into The Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. I'm your host, D Squared. Let's go to the guest line. Actress, writer, director. You'll remember her as Lori Grimes from The Walking Dead, Prison Break as well. Sarah Wayne Callies joins us. Sarah, how are you doing today?
I'm so good, David. How are you?
I am doing fantastic. Let's talk about your new scripted podcast, audio play, whatever you want to call it, Aftershock. It's out now. It deals with an earthquake on the West Coast. Tell the listeners real quick about what Aftershock is.
Well, so in a way, it's the story of the new frontier. It starts off with the earthquake that everybody's always been afraid of. It levels Los Angeles, and 13 miles off the coast in the ocean, a new island rises up out of the sea. And so it's the story of who goes to that island and why, what they're running from, what they're hiding, what they're aspiring to. And you find out pretty quickly that there's a cave full of dead bodies, and people start asking questions about why.
Well, that's just crazy. Dead bodies happen around everywhere, you know. Why are they so worked
everywhere.
Up? Everywhere. I know, right? So let's talk about the fact that you actually wrote this audio play. I don't know why I call it an audio play, because I don't know. It's got so much amazing production value. But you wrote this before the pandemic, right? What was it about this sort of medium that drew you to it?
Well, I mean, I think there's two things about that. Number one is that, you know, in the scripted podcast space, I had the opportunity to co-create, write, direct, produce, and cast and act, which gave me a greater creative voice than I've ever had before in, you know, all the television film that I've ever done, whether it's as an actor and a director. And so that's beautiful, to be able to sort of shape the story and include the people I wanted to include the women of color, the Hawaiian activist, all these people that I'd wanted to write and finally got a chance to. And the other thing that I think is really extraordinary about radio, about the audio space, is that you cannot beat the human imagination. I don't care how much money is in your budget.
Nice.
I don't care how many Marvel movies you make. Our imaginations are attuned to our specific brains and experiences and lives. And so if you can tap into somebody's imaginative brain in the audio world, you can really create something that's so vibrant and so personal at the same time for each listener.
Sarah Wayne Callies is our guest. Her new podcast, Aftershock, is out now on the iHeartRadio app. Now, let's talk about this cast, because this cast is amazing. You've got David Harbour from Stranger Things and now Black Widow, but also Jeffrey Dean Morgan. How did you get these guys on board?
Well, I called them because they're friends of mine. Dave and I went to college together.
Oh, okay, awesome.
And so we go way, way, way back. I met Dave in a directing class. My second year in university and his senior year. Jeff, I've known from the Walking Dead family. You know, we were never in the show together at the same time, but it's actually a relatively close-knit group of people. So I knew him. You know, and I stole Rockman Dunbar from Prison Break. We've been friends for years, and I always thought he's such an incredible actor. And it's just people that I kind of met along the way. Like Russell Hornsby, I'd met doing press for Council of Dads because he was on another NBC show.
Yeah.
We met in a bunch of press lines, and I just think he's this amazing actor. So I just kind of cornered him one day, and I was like, hey, do you want to help me with this passion project for no money that maybe no one will ever listen to? And he was like, well, when you put it like that.
Sign me up!
Came on board. I know. Well, the thing is, you know, a lot of actors really like doing audio work because you don't have to go through hair and makeup. You can just sort of record the whole thing in a day or two in a studio, and you get to do all this really great work without, you don't even have to learn the lines. You can read them.
Right, right.
You can sit there in your pajamas. So everybody kind of came on board because of that. And then, of course, the pandemic hit. And so I was like, actually, just kidding. I have to ship you a mic. You have to cover your closet in pillows and hide under a duvet and download this app. And like, it became this whole much more complicated thing because of the pandemic than I could have expected. And it really tried some people's patience.
I believe that.
I'm grateful that they stuck with me.
Sarah Wayne Callies is our guest. Aftershock is out now on the iHeart app. Look, I've listened to the first two episodes and a couple of compliments right out the gate. One of the hardest things in podcasting, but also in these sort of audio plays, you've got to keep the people interested and hooked through the entirety. And I found myself just sitting there just listening. And then when the commercial showed up, I was pissed. But one of the best parts I thought was David Harbour and you going back and forth. There was a scene where y'all get attacked and you take the gun and you toss it in the ocean. And I guess this is such a testament to your acting skills, because as when you play Laurie Grimes in The Walking Dead, I despised you. That's a testament to your acting skills, because when you did this, though, I was like, why would she throw the gun away? And I just loved how it pulled me in. And that's my long-handed, weird way to compliment you.
Well, thank you so much. I mean, listen, I've always felt as an actor, my job isn't to make people like me. My job is to make people believe the story I'm telling. And if you believe the story, particularly one that I wrote, I'm just super grateful to you. That means the world to me. Really, you know, this is my baby. I've always been a part of shows that other people have created and brought to life in their passion project. And the fact that this time it's mine, anybody who takes the time to give it a shot and to listen, I'm just super grateful to you.
when do the episodes drop? Because you got two out right now. When's the next episode drop?
Every Wednesday. So every Wednesday there'll be a new episode. We've got 10 in the first season, and then there'll be a couple of bonus episodes, a couple of roundtables with the actors, just sort of talking about, you know, what a pain in the ass I am to work for, and how I owe them drinks. I think that's probably how it'll come. We haven't recorded them yet, but I think that's probably what it'll come down to.
That is Sarah Wayne Callies. Sarah, thank you so much for your time today, I don't know how much time I got, but real quick, I see that on social media you're doing a Shop Native, that the indigenous people, you really promote that because of your growing up in Hawaii, right?
Yeah. Yes. Mostly it's because I grew up in Hawaii, and where I came from, Native culture was everywhere. It was in the language, it was in the food, it was in the storytelling, it was in the music and dance. And when I got to the mainland, there was this vast silence, and nobody seemed to know whose land they were on or how to say please and thank you or what foods you could harvest and eat. And it just seemed, to be honest, it seemed kind of rude because it's all Native land.
Right.
And it feels like we should probably be the best guests that we could be.
I dig that. I dig that. Sarah Wayne Callies, thank you so much for your time today. And I look forward to more Aftershock, which is out now on the iHeartRadio app. Thank you so much for your time today, Sarah.
Thank you. Have a great one, D.
You too. All right, coming up next, we have Robert Hayes from Airplane. But he's got a new series coming out called Fasten Your Seatbelt. And I guess fasten your seatbelt and maybe bring your sense of humor back to like the third or fourth grade, because that's exactly where we're going. We're going to potty humor, because you know what? I still find it funny, and Robert Hayes still finds it funny, and people still make money off of fart jokes. So stick around for Robert Hayes coming up next right here on News Talk 99.5 WRNO. You're listening to The Week in Geek.
Yeah, we fancy like Applebee's on a date night. Got that Bourbon Street steak with the Oreo shake and some whipped cream on the top too. Two straws, one shot, girl, I got you. Bougie like Natty in the styrofoam. Sweet squeaking in the truck bed all the way home. Some Alabama jam, she my Dixieland delight. That's how we do, fancy like.
Hey y'all, D Squared here, and I'm joined by a special guest, the Go Forblin, to bring you a special announcement. That's right. Go 4 Games, your friendly neighborhood game shop since 2010, is moving to 4953 West Napoleon Avenue in the Napoleon Plaza. Keep up to date with the move and Go 4 Blend's adventure on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at Go 4 Games NOLA and GoForGamesNOLA.com. What's that? Oh, he says he can't wait for you to see his new pick of location at 4953 West Napoleon Avenue.
This is the Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. Like them on Facebook and follow them on Twitter at Twig Radio. Do it now.
All right, Rob.
Is this David?
Yes, sir. How are you doing today, man?
I am here.
All right.
I'm in Hawaii.
Oh, nice.
Waiting breathlessly for you to be connected with you.
Here we go in 3, 2, welcome back into The Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. I'm your host, D Squared. Let's go to the guest line. You remember this gentleman from Airplane, but also Starman, and he voiced Tony Stark back in the 90s. Robert Hayes joins us. Striker, striker, striker. How many times have you heard that, Robert?
I think I heard it 6 times, I think. No, I don't know. In 41 years, yes. I have heard that a few times.
A few times, but let's talk about your new show on A&E. Wednesday at July 21st at 9 p.m. Central here down in New Orleans. Fasten your seatbelt. It's basically crazy things that happen on the airplanes and get caught on camera. Tell me about it.
Well, they put together this show, Fasten Your Seatbelt, and it's all these crazy things, fun things, heartwarming, funny, MMA style stuff, all these things that happen on airplanes and in airports. And they figured that who else to introduce a clip about airports and airplanes than Ted Stryker. So that's what we're doing. It's what I've seen so far, it's just going to be really fun to watch. I'm actually looking forward to seeing it Wednesday night. And it's the kind of thing, I think people are going to get a kick out of it, and they're going to see these things. They're going to say, hey, wait a minute. I took a picture of this guy doing something stupid on the plane last week when we went to see Aunt Mary. I wonder if they'd like to see this. And they'll start sending in these videos, and then it'll really start going crazy, I think. But for now, they've got quite a collection, and it's fun. It's really been fun.
You know, I mean, I guess everybody's got these airplane stories. You know, you're either stuck on the tarmac for 4 hours, or just somebody decides to take off their shoes and their socks and just walk around the place. It's just, man, sometimes that just works my nerves, bud.
I have been on flights where people have had, I think they wash their feet in sulfuric acid. I mean, it is unbelievable. Or maybe in rotten fish. That's what they wash their feet in, rotten fish. Unbelievable. And it's amazing that they can't tell. They don't know. Or maybe they think that's kind of nice. Maybe that's their aftershave. I don't know. But it's just unwashed feet and bad breath are two things. I make me want to jump out the escape exit.
Or just the people who do this, you know, when they do that on the plane, that's the absolute worst, man. So tell me, Leslie Nielsen.
You mean Leslie Nielsen, you mean?
Yes. Leslie Nielsen, tell me about it.
He did that during my close-ups all the time. Right, with the cameras right on me. Mr. Stryker, can you land this plane? And I've got it the whole time. Mr. Stryker, can you land this plane? I had to keep a straight face because he was off camera. So that was
beautiful.
Rough.
Well, you know, like, what is it about that airplane standing the test of time? You know, they've had some other movies out there, like you were in the superhero movie. But it seems like sometimes they go for, look, I love a good fart joke. I absolutely love a good fart joke. But sometimes it seems like they try to make it cringy when it should be fun and lighthearted like Airplane was.
The guys were and are just, to me, absolute geniuses. The boys, and that's Jerry and David Zucker, Jim Abrams. They're the ones that wrote it, created it, wrote it, directed it. They're the ones who guided the whole thing through its whole creative process to the end, and would screen it and then go back and shave it a little closer together here or extend this laugh a little bit because people were laughing so hard they'd laugh over the setup for the next joke and then they wouldn't get the next joke because
nice.
They'd laughed over the setup. So they'd go back in and have to stretch that one out a little bit. They were brilliant. They really did such an incredible job. And they captured lightning in a bottle. And I think their casting of everybody, of Julie, is just brilliant. Lorna Patterson, who plays Randy, the other stewardess. Bob Stack was their very first choice of any character in the script. The very first one that came to mind for them was Bob Stack.
Never been to a Turkish prison?
Absolutely perfect. And then Leslie, and when they cast Leslie, they said, that's who we want is Leslie Nielsen. And the casting director said, no, what? Who also, you know, they figured we want to get a lot of comedians. And the boys said, no, you don't get it. You don't. This is serious stuff. And they said, we want Leslie Nielsen. And I said, what? That's who you cast? You cast him the night before you're going to start shooting because you can't get anybody else. And they said, no, that's who we want. I was like, oh, God, it's your funeral. Go ahead.
That
so
is awesome.
That's how they got him. And it was them. It was their whole vision of it.
Robert
Thank
Hayes.
Thank God
is-
they have to do it that
yes,
way.
Sir. Robert Hayes is our guest. Fasten Your Seatbelt, A&E, July 21st, 9 p.m. Central. Fasten your seatbelts and jump in for this ride. Now, look, I know we got to go, but real quick, Robert, do you ever plan on maybe getting back into some voice work? Because, like I remember you doing, Tony Stark and the Iron Man in the 90s and stuff, and obviously we're seeing this huge resurgence for Marvel. Where you at? Can you get back on that plane, man?
Well, it's a lot of fun. It really is a lot of fun, and I'd love to do it. Just tell them to give me a call.
Tell them
to give me their number, and I'll call them.
There you go. Robert, thank you so much for your time today. Everybody tune in to Fasten Your Seatbelt. Thank you so much for your time today, Robert.
Well, thank you, and have a great time way down south in New Orleans.
I will. There we go. This is good stuff. Robert, thank you, man.
Pepto Bismol might help that out a little.
All right, Robert, thank you, man.
Thank you, David.
Thank you. All right, guys. Bye-bye. All right, coming up next, we're wrapping up tonight's show with none other than Jamie Lee Curtis when she drops a For the Horde for me. There you go. Coming up next, we wrap up tonight's show on News Talk 99.5 WRNO. You're listening to The Week in Geek.
Matahari, Agent H21, is a spy fiction short story anthology about the famous dancer, seductress, and spy from World War I. Matahari, Agent H21, published by Pro Se Productions, has seven rip-roaring adventure tales about the world-famous super spy that features her battling her enemies by using any weapons at her disposal. Matahari, Agent H21, is available for purchase in ebook and paperback formats on Amazon.com.
Hey, this is Booker T, WWE Hall of Famer, and you're listening to The Week in Geek on WRNO. Now, can you dig that, sucker?
Welcome back into The Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. I'm your host, D-Square. Now, as always, I want to strongly urge you to check out the Facebook page, facebook.com/TheWeekInGeek. Check out our website or not at twigradio.com. Definitely follow us on Twitter at Twig Radio and the Instagrams, The Week in Geek. Now, you can listen to this show a plethora of ways, El Guapo. You can listen it on the free, listen to it on the free iHeart Radio app, Stitcher, YouTube, Spotify, your mama's house, iPhone, iPod, Papple, whatever. You can hear it everywhere, okay? But since subscribe to the Week in Geek radio show on the iHeart Radio app. That way, every time a new pod goes up, you'll get an alert. Now, before I play the Jamie Lee Curtis interview, let me explain a few things that happened. It's kind of short because when the interview opens up, you'll hear these weird popping things. We had a bad connection. So like about 2 minutes into the interview, she just disconnected, and like I'm sitting here talking, and then I realize that nobody's there, and then they call back and we continue the interview with a much better connection. But it was so great because of course she gave me this little gem
for the Horde,
which you will hear shortly coming up. But she and I kind of hit it off right out the gate. She said I could call her a little nickname. It was awesome. So here we go, from beginning to end. Hey, Jamie.
Good morning.
Good morning. Hey, can I call you Jamie? Is that okay?
If I can call you D-Squared, you can call me JLC.
JLC. I like that. We're going to do that. All right, here we go. In 3, 2, 1. Welcome back into The Week in Geek, your source for geek and pop culture news that's trending now. I'm your host, D-Squared. Let's go to the guest line. Actor, director, producer, author, New York Times best-selling author, and now podcaster, JLC Jamie Lee Curtis joins us today. Jamie, how are you today?
D Squared, I am on fire today. I am really, really happy because I'm talking about something that I'm excited about, which is a new podcast on iHeart called, wait for it, Good Friend. It's a podcast about friendship, and I'm really excited about it.
So how did you get in the podcast space? I mean, is it kind of like a byproduct of the pandemic, or is this something that you've always sort of been, you know, intrigued by?
Well, I've been intrigued by it. Two things. I also have a podcast on Audible called Letters from Camp, which is a scripted comedy podcast about a little girl going off to summer camp. So I'm in the podcast world already. But there's a song by an artist that I love named Emily King, and the song is called Good Friend. And when I first heard the song, the idea of a podcast popped into my mind. because I don't know about you, but my experience with COVID was that a lot of my close friendships, and it made me reevaluate a lot of people because we were all separated. And I found that friendship across the board was something that we should be talking about. And so I started the podcast, Good Friend. I interviewed 30 people, some I knew, some I didn't. And iHeart was really excited about it. And they've allowed me this time to have an unscripted, free-flowing conversation about friendship.
And so, where do you start off with some of those conversations? And I mean, your guest list looks pretty spectacular. Niecy Nash from Claws, I love her. Senator Amy Klobuchar, Melanie Griffith, Lena Dunham. I mean, where do you jump off to start the podcast with these people? Because it seems a little daunting.
Some of these people I knew, some people I didn't. To me, the curiosity is, what makes a good friend? What makes a good friend? What do you look for in friendship? And that was usually the starting point. How do you build friendships? I'm one of those people, I don't know about you, but I talk to people in elevators. My family won't go out to dinner with me without saying to me, please don't make any friends at dinner. Because I will talk to the people at my left and my right. I'm interested in people. So in that sense, I found that the first question really is, what do you look for? But, you know, often the conversation just started about how we knew each other, what we all felt about each other, and then it went into friendship. So there was no hard, fast rule about what we talked about. It was just very open-ended, unscripted, very emotional, and pretty deep for a quick hour's podcast.
That is awesome. Yeah, Jamie Lee Curtis is our guest. Look, I'm down here in New Orleans in the South. We just love people. Like, we'll just talk to anybody simply because you're in the grocery store. It's like, hey, what's happening, man? We just sort of do that because we like people genuinely down here. Now, me personally, I'm a giant nerd. The name of the show is The Week in Geek. And when I found out that you are a World of Warcraft fan, I'm like, I want to be JLC's new bestie. How did you get into World of Warcraft? What is it you love about it?
I'm the mom of a card carrying nerd. I've been the team mom for the nerd herd for 25 years. I've raised a nerd. I love a nerd. I love all things nerd. World of Warcraft. Warhammer 40,000.
Boom.
Don't even start with me about the nerd herd.
That is great.
I'm voted. And by the way, for the nerds out there, I just made the movie of Borderlands, and I play Tanis.
Yes.
So I just came back from Budapest, where we shot the movie.
That is awesome. Jamie Lee Curtis is our guest. Her new podcast, Good Friend, is out on the iHeartRadio app or wherever you get your podcast. Jamie, thank you so much for your time today. This truly was a treat. And I'm raising two nerds myself, and you got me all psyched up. I love that. I love giving our passions to our children, because when you see their eyes light up on the same things that your eyes light up, that just as a parent, that is the greatest, glowingest feeling in the world.
It's exactly right. And for me, it was, since I was not a gamer at all, I definitely knew that I needed to lean into what my children were interested in, since they didn't, in my case, seem to be interested in what I was interested in. So I learned, you know, if you can't beat them, join them.
Absolutely. That
and,
is.
You know, and for the horde.
Yes, that is JLC Jamie. Thank you so much for your time. I really do appreciate it.
Yeah, me too. Thank you.
Yes,
God
sir.
Bless.
You too. That's gonna do it for tonight's show. For the Horde, baby. For the Horde.
For the Horde.
Yeah. Want to thank all of our guests tonight. Jeff Bergman, Jellystone, coming out on HBO Max. And of course, Sarah Wayne Callies, Aftershock. Check it out on the iHeartRadio app. Hit that subscribe button. And Robert Hayes, fasten your seatbelt. All right, want to thank once again Jared, Cynthia, Michelle for helping us at MechaCon Man the Table, Woe Man the Table all weekend long. Thank you, ladies. Thank you, Jared. There you go. I'm not sure what's going on next week. I'm going on vacation, so I'm out of here. Till next time, keep your nerd flag raised high.